Well, ladies and gentlemen, right now it is an unbelievable transfer update for you guys. Kareem Adeyemi to Arsenal, man. Wow, that's really crazy, man. That's really crazy. A very interesting prospect. But what is it all about? I'm going to talk about also. Of course, Fabrizio Romano has come up with the most perfect news that I was waiting to hear. William Saliba, vote of confidence from Arsenal. I mean, it was at times you could see that Jorge Sampaoli would want to make that deal permanent for William Saliba to Marseille, but hey, that is not the case anymore. So what did Fabrizio Romano tweet out? It's pretty much simple, you can check it out, but hey, what's my channel for if you know? Check out the tweets, no problem. So Fabrizio tweeted out that Arsenal are following William Saliba's progress closely. They're really happy with French centre-back. Arsenal told Saliba weeks ago that they trust him 100% for the future. He joined Olympique Marseille on loan to play all games as starter. Then he will be back. It is pretty much clear. It is clear. There is no doubt in anyone's mind that, you know, after this tweet, Saliba is in the plans of Mikel Arteta. That's the beautiful part. I think, yeah, I'm really happy. I'm really happy. This made my day. Moving on, Ollie Watkins already, I think this was a very old interview when actually he joined Arsenal or something like that. So he said that that's the dream to play for Arsenal one day, but you know, it's a long shot. I think his grandfather or someone is an Arsenal fan as well. So apparently, yeah, I remember that interview. I actually said that on my one of my episodes as well. So yes, I completely agree that Ollie Watkins to Arsenal would be a very interesting turn of events, if you ask me. But what kind of a striker should Arsenal sign? This is the question for you guys. What type of striker do you want at Arsenal? Just if you could comment and let me know. Like, there's Dusan Vlahovic. We have an update about Dusan Vlahovic as well. We have Dominic Calvert-Lewin, Ollie Watkins being spoken about. Kareem Adeyemi is one for the future that we are going to talk about as well. Lots of things. Also, we have an update about Folwyn Balogun as well. So, but first, let's talk about certain defensive stats for Arsenal so far this season. 7 games played. Here's what they managed to achieve. Most blocks in the Premier League, which includes shots and passes. Fewest times dribbled past. Fewest tackles won. 6th most interceptions. 3rd fewest fouls committed. 4th most aerials won. So I think it's pretty much clear. I think what Mikel Arteta wanted to bring to this team was the aerial prowess this season. And I think he's getting there. He's definitely getting there. I mean, he's really killing that at the moment. So what do we have about Dusan Vlahovic? So here's a big boost for Arsenal and Tottenham. Tottenham just to replace Harry Kane. They were going all in for Dusan Vlahovic. Arsenal, well, they're on the look for a striker. Everyone knows that. So why would these two clubs be on red alert? Because it's pretty much clear. Vlahovic has rejected. Yes, Vlahovic did not accept an offer on the table, but it's pretty much clear that he's rejected the new contract from Fiorentina. So Vlahovic is really making things difficult for Fiorentina, and they are really panicking at the moment. I mean, he's a guy who can really make sure that Fiorentina could even get relegated, or may speak about relegation form if he's out of that team. So it's tough. He's their star man, you know. I hope they don't retire the jersey just like how Birmingham did in respect to Jude Bellingham, but hey, yeah, who does that? Yeah. So according to Fussball.news, Arsenal goalkeeper Bernd Leno could be ousted from the Germany squad. The report claims that his lack of game time at the North London club could lead him to missing out on selection from Hansi Flick's side. I mean, it can happen. I mean, let me know what you guys think about it. I know one thing for sure, that until and unless Manuel Neuer retires, there's no way anyone else is going to topple it. So Leno could get it in 2 years' time. Maybe Leno will get his chance to be the German goalkeeper. But here's something wrong with Marc-Andre Ter Stegen as well. He's not been the best of late. But if Leno does not get any game time, it's not possible for him to make into German national football team. He's not even making an Arsenal football team 11. So by our German national team. But yeah, you need three goalkeepers, right? There are lots of better goalkeepers in the Bundesliga already. So I think, yeah, he's going to lose his spot, yeah. Well, Lacazette's wages, did you know how much Black, of course, we all know 180k a week. But you know how much Arsenal can save if he leaves? Arsenal will save around £9.4 million a year if Lacazette leaves. That is according to Sportrack. The Frenchman is reportedly on around 180k a week, making him the third highest paid player at the club. Thomas Partey and Aubameyang are the top two. Crazy stuff, isn't it? Unbelievable. But let's talk about some other random news. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, it is on the news. According to Daily Mail, Arsenal have joined Liverpool in the race to sign RB Salzburg forward Karim Adeyemi. The 19-year-old has scored 11 goals in 16 appearances for the Austrian side so far this season, and he's won four penalties for them in the Champions League. He's been crazy for them in the Champions League, I'd say that. So Arsenal, Karim Adeyemi, let me know what you guys think about Karim Adeyemi, because I think too young to be true to come to Arsenal, but more importantly, Karim Adeyemi would be he's a baller. He's really good, you know. Karim Adeyemi would be a fantastic signing for Arsenal. Won't be cheap though. Won't be cheap, but I think if Haaland leaves, I think Adeyemi could replace him at Dortmund as well at one point of time. You never know what Dortmund will do. They will definitely ask for a big chunk for Haaland, but let's see if that's possible or not. Well, moving on. Well, a loan deal for Folarin Balogun is being considered at the moment. Football.London understands that Arsenal will consider loan deals in January for Folarin Balogun if his game time is continued to be limited. Of course, new contract makes sure that Arsenal are really cool for the first 2 years now. So I think he should have gone on out on loan straight away. I mean, come on. Us depending on Aubameyang a lot and not giving game time to Lacazette, there's no way anyone else is going to play. It's a Folarin Balogun. I don't know. Probably not another kind of striker that we might be looking at. Will definitely take time to develop. He's just not someone who's going to slot in if Aubameyang doesn't play. So we saw that against Brentford as well. So yeah, that was not going to happen. So yes, let's see what happens. Let's see if that's going to be true or not in the first place. So, off topic, not Arsenal related, but Florentino Perez has said that we hope that on January 1st, everything can be solved about Kylian Mbappe. So, whoa. So it looks like, oh my God, if you have not read that very explosive Kylian Mbappe interview, go check it out. In that, Kylian Mbappe has literally said everything that he was asked, and it was a brutal, it was a straight up honest interview. I would not say it was brutal. It was like, oh my God, what a savage, no? He just was himself, and I think, yeah, that's really crazy stuff. That's really, really crazy stuff. But moving on, so here's an update about Sterling as well. Not only Arsenal who are interested in the Manchester City winger, it's Barcelona as well. Now they believe that Barcelona now have the money to try and sign Raheem Sterling. That is according to a report from Spanish outlet Mundo Deportivo, who say that Barcelona are eyeing a move for the 26-year-old who's been like supremely linked with Arsenal as well. Raheem Sterling to Barcelona. How odd as it may sound, but it's not, you know, Barcelona with their salary capping and with no Messi, of course they need some pace in that wings. And I think, yeah, it'll be really good. But according to Transfer Market, if anyone would want to go and sign Sterling, they would have to pay £81 million. That's the price tag of Raheem Sterling according to Transfer Market. And that's a good price. That's really a good price. So, yeah. Well, let me know in the comments. Only one great thing that I would really like to hear and know. Karim Adeyemi. Do you want Karim Adeyemi to Arsenal? That's the first thing. The second thing that I'd really like to know is, which striker, which type of striker you want Arsenal to sign? Let me know in the comments. Well, I will be reading them, of course, and I will be responding to them as well. So let me know. Okay. I don't know what am I doing, but yeah. So with this, I'd like to end this episode. Thank you so much for watching this. Yeah, consider subscribing. Cheers.